design procedure of the connecting rod. Is it appearing my screen? Hello. Is it appearing on my screen?
Yes, sir. Appearing, sir. Screen.
So in previous class, we discussed about the design procedure of the connecting rod. So what the design procedure? These four points are the procedures are there. First, one by one, sequentially, we need to solve the answers. So in design of IC engine parts, the question is never asked to derive the total design procedure, especially for this fourth unit. This fourth unit, the question not asked for the derive the this total entire design procedure. I have shown here design procedure because of your better understanding purpose. Okay, so what are the parameters we need to design? First one is the dimensions of the cross section of the connecting rod. It means width and height of the connecting rod and the dimensions of the crank pin and piston pin. It means connecting rod is having the big end and one is the small end. Okay, so these two things we have to design in the second parameter. In third one, bolts. So at the big end, the cap is going to assemble with the connecting rod. So to assemble this one, we need a two bolts and nuts. So that we are going to design in here. And thickness of the, how much thickness of the, this cap that we are going to design in here. So these four, after calculating these four parameters, finally we need to calculate the bending stress and we need to check with the permissible value. If our calculated value is less than the permissible value, so then permissible value, then our design is safe. We can write a comment. So this was our previous class. So these are all things we discussed in the previous class. So one numerical problem on the basis of this previous derivation. So first, given it, I'm writing. Given data. Design a connecting rod for IC engine running. So speed is given as 1800 RPM and developing a maximum pressure 3.15 Newton per mm square, and the diameter of the piston is always denoted by capital D, that is bore diameter. Piston diameter, bore diameter, both are same here. That is 100 mm, and the mass of the reciprocating parts per cylinder. So mass of the reciprocating parts, MR value is given, that is 2.25 kg. And the length of the connecting rod, L, 380 mm, and the stroke of the piston, piston, how much given? Stroke of the piston 190 mm, and the compression ratio RC, compression ratio R suffix C, that is given 6:1. Okay, and the factor of safety FS 6, and the length, take the length to diameter ratio for big end bearing as 1.3. I'm writing here length to diameter ratio for big end bearing, how much it is? 1.3. And for the small end bearing, length to diameter ratio for small end and bearing 2 and the corresponding bearing pressures. So bearing pressure for the big end is 10 Newton per mm square and bearing pressure big end then small end. So small end how much? Small end 15 mm. Small 15 mm Newton per mm square. The density of the material is given as density of the material 8000 kg per meter cube and allowable stresses in the bolt. So how much allowable stresses? Allowable stresses in the bolt material 60 megapascal or Newton per mm square. This is for the in a connecting rod, and this is for the cap. Cap value is given 80 megapascal. It means Newton per mm square or Newton per mm square. The rod is I section, so that's the reason I already drawn the I section here, for which you can choose your own proportions. So that reason I selected the my own proportions, B as a 40 and H as a 50, and draw a neat dimension sketch showing the provision for the lubrication, and use the Rankine's formula for which numerator and constant may be taken as 320 Newton per mm square and denominator constant as a (1/7500), and numerator constant is 320 Newton per mm square. Okay, so this is the total entire given data. Now what are the parameters we need to calculate? First one is the, so what is the first one? Dimensions of the, so I'm writing here all the things I'm writing here, just see. Wait, I'm writing here. See, Babu. What are the parameters we have to design here? First one is the determination of the cross section of the connecting rod. So what type of section we are considering here, that is important here. The question is given here already, that is I section. So I section we need to draw first, and after drawing this I section, what proportions we are taking, that we need to show. So that is the total height is a H, capital H. Then my proportion, I'm taking here as a 50. Your wish, you can select a 60 or 70. Okay. Here the width is denoted by capital V, and the proportion I'm taking 40. So your wish, you can select either 3T or 40 or 50. Okay. And the thickness of the web and the flange. This is the web and this is the flange. So these are all the standard one, that is a cap. Small t. Okay, once if you know the t, we can easily find out the this 3t, this head and this total height and the width of this section. Okay, so that is the one here, determination of the cross section of the connecting rod. So this hashed portion is the cross section here. Now here, see how many rectangles are there here in I section? 1, 2 and 3. three rectangle sections are there. Just remember. Okay. One first one, determination of the cross section of the connecting rod. Sorry, not determination, dimensions of the cross section. Cross section of connecting the rod. So here, width of the section is B4T. And height of the connecting rod is H, that is 5T. The difference should be 1 by 4. If you are taking 3 here, this should be 4. If you are taking this is a 4, this would be 5. If you are taking this is a 5, this is 6. Okay. Now, in the previous class, we discussed that the connecting rod is considering as one vertical column and hinged supports at the both ends, and the load is applying, and because of the application of load, it is going to subject into buckling. Okay. Now, the hinging is going to made in about y-axis. Now, buckling is taking place about x-axis. If the we are supporting we are fixing the hinge support the about the y axis, the buckling is going to take place about xx. Suppose if we fix this horizontal axis, now that there is chances to buckle in the about y axis. In the reverse manner, if you fix the xx, then buckling is going to take place yy. If you fix the yy, the buckling is going to take place xx in opposite manner. And also we derive one condition, that is IXX equal 4 times the IYY we derive. It means this condition should be satisfied. If the conditions are satisfied, then whatever the proportions we selected, that proportions are under safe condition. So first, whether if the condition is satisfying or not, we have to check first. So first I am taking calculating the IXX. So what is IXX here? Moment of inertia of the cross section about x-axis. So here now I'm first time verifying with the IXX. So first one, IXX is how much? BD cube by 12, that is I'm writing 1 by 12 4T into 5T cube minus 3T into 3T cube. So total how much? Total how much, Bob? Just tell me the total value in terms of T. Now about y axis I am calculating. 2 into 1 by 12. 2 into 1 by 12. T into 4T cube plus 1 by 12. Into 3T into T
सर आप म्यूट हो सर।
I am audible to you, Babu.
Yes, sir. अभी mute, अभी तक mute है sir आपने.
कितनी देर तक हुआ था?
हाँ.
कितनी देर mute में था?
Around 5 minutes sir. वही एक IFS का formula लिखाना sir, उसके बाद mute चले गए sir आप.
अच्छा. Sorry, Babu. Again, I will explain. So here, IXX first, take the dimensions here, 4T and 5T I am taking. So while taking the dimensions, your wish Babu, here there is no restriction to select the always 4T and 5T. Your wish you can select the 5T or 6T. It means there should be a one digit difference. If you are selecting the 5, you should be 1. Means plus 1, that is a 6 here. There should be a single digit difference. If you are selecting the 6 here, that's here 7. Okay, so this you are proposing the dimensions here. It means this is the not a constant one. This is this may going to change. So after proposing, this is the condition IXS is equal 4 times the IYY. So for that reason, first I am calculating the moment of inertia about X axis. Separately, I am calculating moment of inertia about Y axis. So this is the equation about the x axis. So 1/12 4t bd cube by 12, that is 4t into 5d cube by 12 minus bd cube by 12, that is 3 into 3t cube by 12. So that is the 419/12 into the power of t to the power of 4. In the same manner, IYY also I'm calculating. Okay, now the condition for the our proposed values, I proposed here 4t and I proposed here 5t. These proposed values are under lies under the safe condition or not? That is the condition we have to check here. So to check the condition here, this is the relation I the ratio moment of inertia about x axis by y axis equal 3 to 3.5 range is given. It means here separately we calculated IXX and IYY, calculate the ratio here. So t power 4, t power gets cancelled, 12, 12 gets cancelled, 419/3, 131. It means 3.2. So 3.2 means see 3.5. It means my proposed value, with this my proposed values, the ratio I am getting 3.2. It means my proposal proportions, whatever I selected here, that are under the safe limit. Okay. Now, after getting the confirmation, like under safe limit, write the comments like a because hence IXX by IYY is 3.2, lies between 3 to 3.5. So our proportions, whatever we propose, that are under safe limits. Okay. Now dimensions we are going to further calculate. The first one is B value we have to find out, then H value we have to find out. To get the B value, first what we need here, So here I'm clearly writing 4T, H is a 5T. To get the B and H value, first we need a thickness value. Okay, so to calculate the thickness, I'm now calculating. See here, first see here, the pressure is creating due to the burning action of the fuel on the above the piston surface. So this pressure nothing but force is applying on the connecting rod. It means this force is initially creating on the piston. This force is going to distribute over the connecting rod here. Okay, how much that one? So here, force is acting on a connecting rod, that is equal force acting on a piston. It means piston force equal to the connecting rod force. How much? That is pi by 4 into T square into pressure, maximum gas pressure. So why I am writing this one? Because see, because of this gas pressure only, the force is acting on the piston. This pressure or force is going to distribute it over this connecting rod. So that reason I am equating this one. Nothing but this is the force acting on the piston. Sorry, connecting rod. Now how much this one? Pi by 4 into T square, that is 100 square. How much maximum pressure? 3.15 given in the question. So now calculate it. How much? Tell me the value. Everything is written on the screen. Just tell me the value. Three point one five into hundred. So pi by 4. 3.14. So how much about this one? 24740 newtons. Okay, now the connecting rod subjecting to this much of force due to the gas pressure, and here the connecting rod is going to subject into the buckling force. Buckling force is nothing but the connecting rod is hinged supports at the both ends. So buckling is going to take place about x axis. Okay, and the factor of safety is given in the question as a 6. So buckling load acting on the piston is, sorry, connecting rod is 24740 × 6, 148440. Okay, now radius of gyration about xx axis, that is area, so 419 into T to the power of 4 by 12 into 1 by 11 T square. T square and T power 4 gets cancelled, 1 T outside, 419/11, square root of 419/11 into 12, 1.78. 1.78 into T. Now length of the crank. Length of the crank. R equal stroke of the piston by 2. 190, that is given in the question. 95 mm. Okay, now the length of the connecting rod, question itself given. Length of the connecting rod is 380 mm. Now effective length of the connecting rod. So how much the effective length, see here, because the connecting rod we are assuming here, both ends are hinged support. It is considering as one vertical column, and this vertical column is supporting with the two ends at the top and bottom as a hinged support. So now effective length, capital L, is considered as a smaller, that is 380 mm. Okay, that is the capital L. And now I am taking the Rankine's equation. Critical load about x-axis, W, B equal sigma C into A by 1 plus A into L by K about x-axis power square. Now sigma C is question itself given, that is 320 megapascal. Now area of the rectangle, but total area is 40 into T plus 3T into T. This is the total area. So twice is because two flanges are there and one web is there. So how much? 11 T square by 1 plus constant value, numerator, so denominator constant value is given, question itself, that is 1 by 7500. Effective length 380. And radius of gyration, how much? 1.78 into T. So simplify it. WB value we got 148440 equal 320 into 11 T square by 1 plus 1 by 7500 380 by 1.78 into T whole square. So 148440 by 320 equal 11 T square by 1 plus 380 by 1.78 whole square. So 6.123, this means 6.1 I'm writing round figure, by T square. So it means 11 T power 4 by T square plus 6.1. Okay. Four 64 T square plus 6.1 is equal to 11 T power 4. So T power 4 11 t power 4 minus 464 t square minus 464 into 6.1 is equal to 0. That is t power 4 minus 42.2 t square minus 257.3 equal to 0. So what is the roots of this equation? The roots of the equation, so here it is a power 4, here is a square, so difficult to calculate these roots. So one solution we have, p is equal to square root of b plus r minus square root of 4ac b plus r minus, one equation is b plus r minus square root of c square, so b square plus 4ac by 2. So in this, by using this equation, we are calculating the roots of this equation. So let's see here. So what roots we are calculating for the t value? So t equal 42.2 plus or minus square root of 42.2 square plus 4 into a into c is the 257.3. Now tell me the t value here, how much? So see here, only positive, take the positive sign, neglect about the negative sign here, consider the positive sign. Now tell me the t value. Consider only positive sign, neglect about the negative sign. Tell me the t value. Now t is the 6.9, it is nearly equal to 7 mm. Now thickness we calculated. Now what is the width of the connecting rod? 4 times the thickness, that is 4 into 7, that equal to 28 mm, and the height is 5t, that is 5 into 7, that is 35 mm. Now depth of the additional one, depth near to the big end, that is H1, depth near to the big end, that is H1, 1.2 H, that is called 1.2 into H value 35, and depth near to the small end, that is H2, that is equal to 0.85 into H, 0.85 into 35, that is equal to 29.7. How much is this one? 1.5 into 35? 42. Now dimensions of the connecting rod at the big end, dimensions of the connecting rod at the big end is 40 28 35 42 42 into 28 mm, and at the small end the dimensions of the connecting rod is 30 into 28. Okay, so these are the dimensions we have to calculate for the cross section. What cross section? Question itself given as a I section. Okay, and now second one is the dimensions of the big end crank pin and dimensions of the piston pin. So first one, considering DC as a diameter of the crank pin and LC is the length of the crank pin. So the standard empirical relation is there, and this is the standard empirical relation, and here question also mentioned this is a ratio, L by D ratio for the big end connecting rod 1.3. The question itself mentioned. So based on crank for LC is equal to 1.3 into DC. And the bearing pressure, question itself given for the bearing pressure for the big end, that is 10 Newton per mm square. Okay. Now, the load acting on the crank pin, how much that is a project bearing pressure into bearing pressure at the big end into area, projected area. What is the projected area here? L into D. Okay. So here L value is given in terms of D, that is 1.3 into DC. Okay. So now 10 into 13, 1.3 into DC square, DC and DC. Here 1.3 into DC, already DC is there, square. So how much is this one? 13 DC square. Okay. And now this load is acting on the crank pin, that is equal to the forces acting on the connecting rod, FC. So how much that one, the force acting on the connecting rod? 24740 equal 13 into DC square. So this one we calculated in the previous case above. Okay, so now DC square equal 24740 by 13. Now how much is this one? 1903. Okay, and DC how much? So here it is a square, applying square root here to remove this one. Now how much the DC here? 43.6, that equal nearly 44 I am taking mm. Okay, now DC is the diameter of the big end of the connecting rod of the diameter, and now LC, we don't know the LC, the relation is given, that is 1.3 into 44. Now how much the LC value? 1.3 into 44, that is 57.2, that is nearly equal to 58 mm. So this dimensions for the big end. Now small end, I'm calculating the small end. Small end connecting rod, DP, small end connecting rod is nothing but piston pin. At the piston pin, we can find the small end. So DP I'm writing. DP is the diameter of the small end connecting rod, and LC is the length of the piston pin, and the bearing pressure for the piston pin is given in the question itself, Newton per mm square. Okay, so the load is acting on the piston due to the bearing pressure is 15 into the ratio is given here, LP ratio for this question. How much is that given? 2 DP. So bearing pressure into area, that is L into T, LP into DP. So 15 into LP, how much given? 2 DP. 2 into DP, and already one D is there, that is square. Now I am equating these two forces acting on the connecting rod due to the gas pressure. How much that one? 24740. Now what is DP square here? 24740 by 2. How much? 2 into 15, sorry, 15. Now what is D? Remove the square, that is, what is DP here? 28.7, nearly equal to 29 mm. Now what is LP value here? 58 mm. Okay, so this is the second point. Now what is the third point? Third point is dimensions. Third point, size of the bolt and nuts. So size of the bolt is here denoted by DC CP. It means core diameter of the bolt. Core diameter of the bolt. Okay. And see here, the connecting rod is always subject into the tensile action here. The big end of the cap, big end of the connecting rod cap is always subject into the tensile force. So that's the reason the bolts, whatever they are using here, the bolts are also subject to the tensile force. Now respective stress is a tensile stress. So based on how much resisting force is required here, the resisting force on a bolt is pi by 4 into DC for the bolt square into tensile stress. So how much tensile stress? Question itself given tensile stress. How much this one? 60 newton per mm square. Question itself given. Okay. And here how many bolts we are using here? 2 bolts we are using here. That is multiplied with 2. Okay. So that is pi by 4 into 2 to the 4. So DCB we don't know. Okay. So the resisting force on the bolts, that is equal to pi by 2 into DC bolts square into 60. Okay. Now resisting force we need. So how we can calculate the resisting force here? Because the connecting rod is always subject to the inertia forces. So that inertia forces we are equating to here resisting force of the bolt. So what is the inertia force here? MR into omega square into R. This MR is the mass of the reciprocating part, angular velocity of the reciprocating part, crank radius into cos theta plus cos 2 theta by L by R. And now question mentioned here that and the crank is at the top dead center. So when it is a top dead center, the theta is going to consider as a zero. Cos zero. That is MR into omega square into R into cos theta is a one plus R by L. Okay. So MR value question itself given 2.25 kg. And omega value, speed is given, omega is its relation 2 pi n by 60. Okay, so 2 into pi into speed is given in the question 1800 by 60 whole square, and crank radius is given in the question that is 0.095 crank radius. into 1 plus 0.095 by length. Length how much? 0.38. Now simplify this one. How much? So otherwise, directly we can substitute in the calc. Just tell me the value of Fi. How much is the Fi value? Inertia force is acting on a connecting rod. 2.25 into 2 by 1800 into 260 by whole square. 0.95 94 90 newtons. Now equate this Fi to resisting force on a bolt. 9490 newtons. So after equating, what is DC? See here, pi by 2 is a constant and this is an unknown parameter and 60 of 9490. What is dB? Square equal 100.7. Now what is DCB? Core diameter of the bolt, how much? 10.03 mm. And the nominal diameter, the relation is nominal diameter of the bolt is core diameter of the bolt by 0.84. That is 10.03 by 0.84. So now how much is this one? 11.94 mm. Diameter, nominal diameter of the bolt is 11.94 mm. This is the third point. Now final, the fourth point is thickness of the beginning of the connecting rod. That is denoted here, thickness of the cap TC. Okay, so this one we need to calculate. And BC, the width of the big end of the cap is BC, big end of the connecting rod. Width of the big end, width of the connecting rod is, that is equating to LC, that is 58 mm. And sigma B value, question itself given 80 megapascal. Okay. Bending stress equal bending moment by section modulus. So bending moment is PC into TC square by 6, that is 58 into TC square by 6, 9.7 into TC square. Okay, this M value, Bob, this is the M value. Now Z value, the Z value is a PC into TC. Sorry, this is the Z value. M value is inertia force into x by 6. So what is the x here? X is nothing but distance between the bolt centers. So suppose this is the connecting rod cap. Here one bolt we are using, here one bolt you are using. So this distance is referred as x. How much this x? The x value I am calculating here, diameter of the first one, x value I am calculating. Dia of crank pin plus, why is the thickness of the bearing? Bearings plus nominal diameter of bolt DB plus clearance. So this total relation shows the distance between the bolt centers. Okay. So DC diameter of the crank pin DC, that is plus 2 thickness of the bearing to 3. Just mm. So inertia forces, just now we calculated 9490 into how much this one core diameter we got as a 446 plus DB. DB, how much we got? So here I forgot DB. DB, how much? DB I got as a 12. So 44 plus 6 into 12. 44 into 6 plus 3 plus 12. So total, how much? 65 by 6. This is the M value. Now substitute the, what is M value? Separately I'm calculating. 9490 into 65 by 6. 102810 mm. Sub-Newton mm. Now section modulus is 9.7 T square. Now substitute in this equation. Sigma B is given in the question 80. Now what is the unknown here? The unknown one is the TC value. So TC value how much here? TC value how much? After substituting the Z value here and after substituting the M value here and the sigma B value is given in the question. So what is the T value? Which one is unknown here? TC value. That one we are calculating here. Okay. And now check the design under the safe condition or not. So for checking purpose, what we have to do here, see, in same manner, separately we have to calculate the bending stress. Okay, so our bending stress value we have to compare with the cushion value. So that is a, this is a calculated value. This is a calculated value and this is a permissible value. So this calculated value should be less than the permissible value. It means whatever we calculated, that should be less than the permissible. The permissible value will be given in the question. So then our design is safe. Okay. So to calculate this one, sigma B, what is the relation? Same equation, M by Z, bending moment by section modulus. So what is the section modulus here? Okay, Babu, this last part we'll discuss in the next class. Sir is waiting. Just wait. I'm taking the attendance.